cake. Joey.
Hi, I'm calling over here in Karen Henry.
Alive and
yes, this is Jennifer.
This is.
Hi. No, that's okay. Thanks for calling me back. I'm sitting here in the room with your mom.
Okay.
And we're trying to make plans for her to go home. You know, she has not heard good news from her physician.
You know what?
At celebration.
I don't know what that news is because I can't keep. I've been trying to get the doctors and everybody. I miss them and the nurses don't talk to me.
Sorry?
I don't even know what that news is.
You don't know what is? What the hospice is?
I don't know what this is. What that's.
Your mother. Your mother has appointed you as her healthcare surgeon. My understanding is that she moved down here from Michigan with you guys, and that she lives with you in your home.
Yes.
And you know that she's been under treatment for her breast cancer.
Yes.
And that she has been getting sicker recently.
Yes. That's as much as we know.
And she's been in the hospital since the 12th of January here at Celebration.
Yes, I brought in the power attorney. I see her regularly, but she's been kind of hallucinating and from the medicine. So I've been trying to find out from the nurses, and I've tried staying long enough to catch the doctors, but it's never happened.
Okay, well, would you like to speak with her nurse right now? She's standing here.
Yes, please.
Okay, she's going to give your mom her pain medication. I am also a nurse, and I can tell you that your mom has been recommended to hospice care.
Why?
And because there is no more treatment available for her, very rapidly spreading cancer that has spread to her liver and to her and is causing her problems with her breathing. My name is Connie Miller. I'm with Cornerstone Hospice.
Yeah.
Afraid I'm giving your wife unexpected bad news.
Okay. I'm not convinced it's over with yet.
For you, a horrible mom.
When I look into your
what's happened to you in the last
like
few
days? Watching the night.
I brought you.
I'm so happy to see you.
All the beautiful
Mom, what's happened? Why do you look so bad? It's only been 2 days.
And just
Mom,
like them
I don't know what to do.
I don't either.
I see that you've
I'm
come
devastated.
So far.
About Devin, what have they said?
To be right where you are.
I talked to Beth. Mom, why are you got wounds on your lips and nose?
Well, oh, my nose. Just oh, I get those wounds.
Even if the sky
I know, Mom, but your mouth is black.
Giving you all
well, that's because I constantly get a little thing.
Still looking up.
Mom, why didn't
I'm you not convinced when it's
over. It is over, Mom.
No, I don't think
they told me it is.
To do some navigating, I'll
they
be
patiently waiting.
They didn't know anything until they did their test.
Mom, you've been in here almost 3 weeks. I have constantly asked them for information. I didn't care. We were supposed to go to Michigan. day, but it rained. It's pouring rain. It's like it wasn't Rachel. And yesterday, I put up all like the collage pictures on the wall, kind of straightening things up for you to come home. The lady on the phone. Someone who wants to waste the reason they are here to stay and make the difference that I can make. I'm like, what are you talking about? They said they were going to teach us how to use and then in his last word, he said hospice. And I broke down and I'm like, what the hell? Not one thing has mentioned anything. I'm not watching you start the FBI. We didn't burn. I can't do it. Is letting them use his sky miles, half his sky miles to get Paul. Hopefully Rachel here too.
No, Rachel can't come.
Because it takes two to whisper quietly. The silence isn't so bad till I look at my hands and feel sad. Cause the spaces between my fingers are right where yours fit perfectly. I'll find repose in new ways, though I haven't slept in 2 days. Cause cold nostalgia chills me to the bone. But drenched in as men.